Hey, this is Alex from downtown Montreal, and you're listening to the Weekend Game Plan on TSN 690.
Wish we could turn back time to the good old days when the mama sang us to sleep, but now we're stressed out. Wish we could turn back time to the good old days when the mama.
7:51 on TSN 690. It is Weekend Game Plan. I'm your host, Matthew Ross. Dave Trentadue here as well. We're here till 9 o'clock. Habs breakfast segment coming up just after 8 o'clock with Andrew Zadernowski of HabsEyesOnThePrize.com and Amanda Stein here in studio. Time to talk college sports. And normally we have Mo Khan with us, but we have a special treat today. We welcome in from the Concordia men's basketball team, the head coach, Rastko Popovich, joins us here live on the program. How you doing, coach?
I'm doing great. Thanks for having me this morning, Matt.
Well, thanks for waking up early and chatting with us. Appreciate your time. The men's team right now for Concordia, I'm an alum, so certainly a fan of the program. You are 4-4 right now, right in the thick of the RSCQ division. A couple of games in hand on the leading team, which is McGill right now. It's 7-3. Are you about where you thought you would be at this point?
Well, I mean, we had, out of the four losses, we had 2 1-point losses that are kind of games that could have went either way. So, like you said, it's a very tight league. We know each other well. Each time we play a team, we've played each other 3 or 4 times by now, so everybody knows each other well. So the games are extremely competitive, so some games will go either way. But I think we're in a good position right now with 2 games in hand, which could be 1 game out of first place by next weekend if we take care of our games against Bishops.
How would you describe the team right now? Is it a veteran team, a mix, a young team?
I definitely say we're a young team. I mean, we only have one fifth-year player who's graduating this year, and then maybe a couple fourth-year guys. Everybody else is either in their first and second year. So we're a very young team. We had a good recruiting class this year. A lot of those first-year guys are playing a lot this year. And, you know, I think that's good for us that they're getting all this experience during the season, so they'll be more ready playoff time. But I definitely consider us a young and upcoming program.
We're chatting with the head coach of the Concordia men's basketball team, Rastko Popovich, here on Weekend Game Plan. The Concordia Stingers men's team will next play January 26th versus Bishops. Who's your main competition, do you think, in this division? Do you still say it's, like you mentioned at the top, that it's close and anybody can take out anybody? Or do you view McGill as cream of the crop or yourselves? Do you guys think you can get on top? How do you look at it?
Well, I mean, I think McGill's been, the last couple of years, McGill's been the best team in the conference. Coach DeVito's done a great job there, and I think, you know, they're the defending champions, so we got to give them that respect. But, you know, this weekend we had 2 very close games. We won on Thursday, and they beat us last night. Very competitive games. But teams like Laval and UCAM have very good teams as well with a lot of talent. So every game is competitive, and if you don't show up one weekend, you can go from second place to fourth place really fast. So I think it's important to take it one game at a time. But like I said, at this point, McGill's in first place and they're a team to beat.
I've taken my girls to watch the women's team in the past at the gym on Sherbrooke at the Loyola campus for the Stingers. And it's a lot of fun. It's a lot of fun to watch because you have a great seat no matter where you're sitting. Tell the fans if they haven't been out to a university basketball game here in Montreal, who they should be looking out for on your team. Who's an exciting player that we should be talking about?
Well, it should definitely be Ken Beaulieu, who's a fourth-year guard on our team. He's one of the most exciting guys in the league, also in the country. He's a high flyer. He gets, you know, he'll produce exciting dunks throughout the games. He's very, very fun to watch. Just this past Thursday, we had a almost sold-out crowd against McGill at Concordia's gym. And if you've been in the gym, you know how small it is. But if it's packed, it's a very, very fun venue to play at. And it was a great atmosphere, and I think, you know, an average fan should come and take a look at one of the games because it's really exciting. These student athletes work really hard the whole week to prepare for these games, and I think it's rewarding for them when there's a lot of people to come and watch them.
Before we let you go, I want to get your take very quickly on the new Alouettes president. You had a chance to work, I'm sure, with Patrick Boivin, who was the athletic director there at Concordia. Your thoughts on him now moving on to the Montreal Alouettes?
Well, obviously, I think it's a very exciting opportunity for Patrick and something that he couldn't pass on. And I think he did a great job at Concordia. We had a lot of, you know, new young coaches that came in, and all the programs are going in the right direction. But like I said, I think it's a great opportunity for him career-wise. And I think it's it's a wise decision on his part to take that position. And I think he's going to do a great job there.
Stingers.ca, if you want more information on any of the sports, including the men's basketball team. As I mentioned, they'll next play against Bishops at Concordia January 26th. That's an 8 p.m. game. And it's also available, actually, on the web as well through Stingers.ca. Coach, thank you so much for your time. Best of luck the rest of the season.
All right, thanks, Matt. Thanks for having me. Have a good day.